the key to recognizing talent is to challenge yourself and the organization to not just take the easy data points as an indicator of who someone is and what their potential is going forward. A classic example of that is simply looking through resume books and searching for single numbers, GPAs, SAT scores, revenue figures if you're an experienced hire. Important indicators, regardless of where at school you're coming from or the classes you've taken, being successful and achieving top marks is an indicator of intensity and success. But organizations have to and have become more sophisticated in how they assess what the individual's potential is in the organization going forward. At Goldman, one of the things that was most important for us was to take a step back from the process and really think about what we were looking for in our candidates. And it's not just an HR project, it's HR expertise, talent expertise, combined with business leaders' perspective of what was most important in someone's job. We held ourselves accountable. We didn't just look at what was successful in the past. We wanted to know what was important going in the future. You couldn't just look at schools that were successful in the past because guess what? That would just project that going forward. And so we went from a process that was heavily reliant on quantitative metrics to one that were a process that was more qualitatively based, where we used indicators and words that we felt were a better reflection of one's ability to solve problems, use judgment, work collaboratively within a team. When you move beyond the highly data-centric way of recognizing talent to one that's more inclusive of people's experiences and understanding, you know, the individual, what results is that you hire a broader type of person. People often, historically, would take the straightest line. And the straightest line is what's familiar to you. And so it's not unusual in the past for a business to have a lot of people from the same school or a lot of people who are ethnically and economically similar. And that's just not a viable way to run an organization anymore. And so taking that unintentional but real bias out of the system will lead to a broader set of candidates that you're considering in the first instance and people that you're recognizing as truly talented going forward. I mean, times are currently, if you walk into an organization and everyone is similar in the way they interact and the way they represent the way they are, I would argue that you're not hiring the best people. You're just not hiring the best people. And so moving away from a point, I call it a point in time evaluation of an individual as is reflected in stats on their resume to a real understanding of the individual's story and capabilities will lead to a stronger workforce, which will therefore be more diverse.